Hello, good morning students. In the last class we were discussing about Los Angeles abbreviation test and I told you that we will continue in the next class. Today we will see in detail. However, in the last class we have seen that any grade of aggregate on which the test may be performed using Los Angeles apparatus. There are 7 grades A to G and size of aggregates which are to be tested may be different. Accordingly, it has been graded by IS 2368 code of practice. For example, I said for a grade, we have to take 1.25 kilo, passing through 40 mm and retained on 25. Similarly, 1.25 kilo, passing 25, retained on 20. And passing 20, retained and 12.5 kgs, 12.5 passing and 10 mm retained, 1.25 total, 5 kilo aggregate you have to take. And along with that, in order to simulate the field condition, you have to take number of spears, that is iron balls, cast iron balls, 12 number as per the specification. This differ and size of aggregate also differ from grade to grade. Okay, that is the concept. If you understand the concept, you can refer to the table and take conveniently whatever is required. This is the apparatus which we use for conducting Los Angeles abrasion test. This is. So, we have to provide 500 revolutions. If it is A, B, C, D grade, for E, F, G grade, we have to go for 1000 revolutions. You need not have to count revolution. Once you start the machine and rotate when it is empty without any cast iron balls inside, without noise, you count how many number of counts or how many number of times it rotates in 1 minute. Therefore, 500 revolutions divided by that time taken for number of rotations taken by 1 minute, you will get total minutes to be allowed the machine after the sample is collected and put it into the equipment. Okay, abrasion test is carried out to test the hardness property of the aggregates and to decide whether they are suitable for different pavement construction works or not. Los Angeles abrasion test is preferred for carrying out the hardness property and has been standardized in India by IS, as I already said, 2386 part 4. The principle of Los Angeles abrasion test is to find the percentage wear due to relative rubbing action between the aggregate and steel balls used as abrasive charge. In field, how it is friction and abrasion takes place between the wheels and the pavement, and even some sand particle or fine particle may come in between wheel and the pavement when they are producing abrasion, right? Recommended result of abrasion test. Abrasion value of aggregate should not be more than 30%. For aggregate used for surface wearing course, and should not be more than 45% for surface and other wearing courses. Standard guidelines for abrasion test is given in 2386 1963 and BS 812 113 1990. Operators for abrasion test: Los Angeles abrasion machine, steel balls 11 number, for B grade, for A grade 12 number. Weighing balance, sieves, depending upon grade, what are all the sieves, sizes of aggregate to be taken, passing retained, you have to consider. The Los Angeles abrasion testing machine consists of a circular drum mounted on a horizontal axis so that it can be rotated. The drum is then rotated for a total of 500 or 1000 revolutions, as I said, for different grades. However, you will be doing in detail during the practical work or practical hours, term work, then we will see in detail. Okay, so after the test is over, you have to sieve through 1.7 mm IS sieve for Los Angeles abrasion testing. After test is completed, you have to take a sieve 1.7 mm IS sieve, find weight of passing material through 1.7 mm IS sieve, then abrasion value is equal to, suppose if I call small w is the weight of the fine passing through 1.7 mm and capital W total weight of the aggregate taken, that is however 5 kilo, irrespective of the grade you have to take 5 kilo, then multiplied by 100 you will get it in percentage. According to this value we can consider the suitability as it has been already stated earlier. Next, impact test. This is the impact test apparatus. This you have seen in the workshop or in a TOM laboratory in second year also, testing on materials which you have done. In that case even impact test machine you have seen. Here aggregate may be subjected to sudden shock or impact. Aggregate may be subjected to a sudden shock or impact during as well as after the construction, not only after the construction, even during also. These loads are different from the gradually applied compressive loads. Due to such kind of loads, aggregate breaks down into smaller pieces. In order to simulate or evaluate the resistance to impact of aggregate, the aggregate impact test is considered. In order to evaluate impact of aggregate, test is to be performed. Aggregate impact gives the idea about how much impact load can be resisted by aggregate. Actually, aggregate should be sufficiently tough to resist their disintegration due to impact. The distinctive property can be assessed, that is nothing but toughness property due to impact. Now, standard guideline for impact test, you can get it from IS 2386, part 4, 1963. Aggregate impact apparatus is required. IS sieves 12.5 mm passing, retained on 10 mm. It is same as in case of crushing value test. After the test is performed, 2.36 mm IS sieve is to be taken and fines weight is to be found out. Cylindrical measure and cylindrical cup, weighing balance and tamping rod as usual as in case of aggregate crushing value test which you have studied. Here during the test you have to provide in this test, impact test, this hammer 13.5 plus or minus 0.5 kg weight is to be lifted along these vertical guides. As soon as it is lifted, it will fall down. Such an arrangement is made, automatically it falls down at a fall of say 38.5 plus or minus 0.5, around 40 centimeter height it falls down. How many number of blows should be given? 15 number of blows should be given so that it it is applied over the aggregate which is filled in the steel cup. This is the steel cup. So in this steel cup, you have to fill the aggregate passing 12.5 retained and 10 mm. So in detail about the practicals, we will see in the term work class during practical hours. Right? Theoretical concept is that much. So after you find the fine weight, fine weight passing through 2.36 mm sieve, you can find impact value in percentage is equal to impact value in percentage is equal to weight of fines passing through 2.36 mm sieve divided by capital W, that is the total weight of the aggregate taken, multiplied by 100 in percentage. Okay. Further, the suitability with respect to which in which course it can be used, etc., we will study in detail in the practical class. Otherwise, it becomes unnecessarily over teaching for you. Soundness test. This test requires at least 2 days, 15 cycles you have to carry out. Soundness test, just we shall see what is soundness test. Soundness test on aggregate is conducted to understand the resistance of aggregates to weathering action. So important is here is weathering action. How weathering action affects the quality of aggregate is to be seen, that is by soundness. Aggregates are subjected to the physical and chemical action of rainwater groundwater and the other impurities of the atmosphere. Aggregates which are subjected to the physical and chemical action of either rainwater, groundwater and the other impurities of atmosphere. This can lead to a change in the volume which is not good and substandard for the durability of construction. Therefore, the property of aggregates to weather and the adverse action of weather is known as soundness of aggregate. Toughness, impact. Hardness property, abrasion test. Compressive strength, crushing test. Like that, soundness test is with respect to weather action and adverse effect of weather. Importance of soundness, that much we will see. This we will not be going to conduct the practical because it requires at least 15 cycle, 2 cycles, 2 days. Soundness test on aggregates indicates the durability of aggregate. It shows the aggregates to resist the adverse effect of weather. The soundness test is carried out in order to find the resistance of aggregates to weathering actions like thawing, freezing, alternate thawing, freezing and drying in normal condition and variation in temperature in salt water. When aggregates fall to resist such conditions, then it is said to be unsound. Recommended result of soundness test. Recommended result of soundness test should not more than 12% and 18% after 10 cycles. See here, 10 cycles at least you have to complete. 10 cycles when tested with sodium sulfate and magnesium sulfate respectively. It should not be more than 12% if it is mixed and tested with sodium sulfate. Sodium sulfate if you use, it should not be more than 12%. If you use magnesium sulfate, it can be up to 18%. Standard guidelines, it is also similar. IS 2386, instead of part 4, part 5. Apparatus for soundness test, sodium sulfate or magnesium sulfate solution. O1, weighing balance, IS sieves, weight balance. Right? So we will not take more on this. Next, shape test. We will continue in the next class. We will stop here. These are the instruments used for shape test. length gauge, this is length gauge, this is thickness gauge. In detail from the beginning we will see in the next class. Okay, thank you. Go through once and come for the next class. We will take in the next class. Thank you. We'll stop here.